In this lesson, I will show you how you can create embossed or debossed text objects. In the open file, I have created a floor and two walls. In the following examples, I will place 3D text objects on these walls. You can activate the 3D text tool if you expand the tools menu and select the 3D text option. Alternatively, you can click on the 3D text icon from the toolbar on the left. Once I activate the tool, the Place 3D Text window appears. In the field where the phrase Enter Text appears, you can type the text. In this example, I will type the phrase SketchUp Pro. From the font selection drop-down, you can select the font you like best. As you can see, there is a wide variety of fonts to choose from. In my case, I will select Times New Roman, which is one of the most frequently used fonts. Right next to the font drop-down, there is another drop-down from which you can select whether the text will appear regularly or if the letters will be bold, italic, or even bold and italic at the same time. Personally, I will select the bold option. Right below the font drop-down is the align drop-down. The options for the text alignment are left, center, or right. At this point, I won't change the center option, which is the default option. Another important field is the height field, which defines the size of the letters. I will not change the default letter size, and I will move on to the last two options. With the filled option enabled, each letter of the text will be a surface, while with the extruded option enabled, the text will be extruded. To define the amount of volume the text will have, I will type the exact number of the extrusion in the field on the right. So, I will type the number 0.05, and finally, I will click on Place to place the text in the scene. Note that the solid object of the text has been created, and I can place it on any surface. I will click on the wall's surface to place it there. Notice that the text is embossed on the wall. At this point, I should mention that text objects have the same properties as solid objects. Therefore, if you want to edit this object, you will edit it like you would with any solid object. For example, let's assume that I want to delete the word Pro. I will double-click on the text, select the word Pro, and press Delete to remove it. Then, I will click somewhere on a random point to exit the edit mode. Now I will select the text, and then I will activate the Move tool to create a copy of the text. I will click to set the base point and press the Control key to create a copy. Finally, I will click on a point on the surface to place the copied object. Now, let's say that I want this text to be debossed on the wall. To achieve that, I will select the text, and then I will activate the Subtract tool from the Solid Tools toolbar. While the text is selected, I will click on the wall from which I want to subtract the volume. Notice that the text is now debossed on the wall.